ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணா ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணா ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணா ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணா. குருர் பிரம்மா குருர் விஷ்ணு குருர் தேவோ மகேஸ்வர குரு சாட்சாத் பிரம்ம தஸ்மை ஸ்ரீ குருவே நம தஸ்மை ஸ்ரீ குருவே நம. There is humming going on, do something. Andhatva mandatva patutva dharma, no. Is it better now? அந்தத்வ மந்தத்வ படுத்வ தர்மா சௌகுண்ய வைகுண்ய வசாத் சக்ஷுஷா மாதுரிய பாதிரிய மூகத்வ முகாஸ்தவத்தைவ ஸ்ரோத்ராதி தர்மா நதுரேத்துராத்மனஹா. லைக் தி கார்பெண்டர் ஹேஸ் ஹீஸ் டூல்ஸ் வைல் ஒர்க்கிங், பிளேனர், ஆக்ஸ். இன் த சேம் மேனர் த subtle body is the tools for the one who is expressing through the body. Gross body is house. Subtle body is the tools. Therefore, when the tools get spoiled, nothing happens to the carpenter. Similarly, when the eyes become blind, nothing happens to me. When the ears become deaf, nothing happens to me. They belong only to the upadhi. Similarly, prana, the dharma of the prana, are ashana pipase, hunger and thirst. They belong to the prana, not to me. But when we get identified with them, then alone the cinema starts. Therefore, the principle of ahankar is now indicated. These are very subtle points. If we don't understand with reference to context, confusion is bound to be. Mana, buddhi, chitta, ahankar, antakaran, chatushtay. Four. Then, பூமி ராப்போ நலோ வாயு கம் மனோ புத்தி ரேவச்ச அஹங்கார் இது எம்மே பின்னா பிரகிருதி ரஷ்டதா. தேர் அஹங்கார் இஸ் எ தத்துவ. பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தி அஹங்கார் தத்துவ, த ஃபைவ் எலிமெண்ட்ஸ் ரிமெயின் இன்டிகிரேட்டட் இன் த ஃபார்ம் ஆஃப் த பாடி. ஸோ ஹியர் த மீனிங் ஆஃப் அஹங்கார் இன் பிரகிருதி இஸ் நாட் ஈகோ. வேர்ட் இஸ் த சேம், but what context it is used. Like when Bhagavan Krishna says, maya tatamidam sarvam jagadavyakta murtina, that time he is not referring himself as Devaki Putra or Yashodanandan. What is the same I? See, I am very angry. Who is angry, please? Husband. So, I am very happy. Who is happy? Husband. This is just example. So, this word I must be understood with reference to context. So, when ahankar is said, it is tattva, one way. The second one. Antakaranameteshu chakshuradishu varshmani ahamityabhimanena tishtati abhasa tejasa. Now be attentive. The absolute conscious reality reflecting in the subtle body. So, conscious reality, subtle body, and reflection of the self in the subtle body, these three things together is called as a phenomena ahankar. or aham rather, let us put it only aham. Car is not given to him as it. See, therefore aham iti abhimanena. So one gets identified with that. Now, like reflection in the mirror is a natural process. You can't stop it. In the same manner, conscious reality reflected in this subtle body and the reflection happens and this reflection gets identified with the subtle body, gross body, etc. That principle is called as aham. So aham is everywhere. In deep sleep, when the mind is closed, meaning when the mirror is removed, there cannot be reflection. Therefore, in deep sleep, there is no aham. There is only life. See? So, aham iti abhimanena tishtati abhasa tejasa. Abhasa is reflection. So these three principles should be clear. Paramatma reflected in the prakriti plus the reflection. Three things together. Now, ahankarasya vijneya karta bhokta abhimani ayam. Now this phenomena, he starts associating with action, I am the doer, and associating with the joy, I am the enjoyer. Now take this example which I am giving again and again. Husband thinks, I am doing so much for her, but I am suffering. The man is not doing anything. The husband says, I am doing everything for her. The man never says, I am suffering. It is the husband who says, I am suffering. So see the difference. The husband is a phenomena, and this phenomenal existence, things which is actually abhivyakti, which is actually manifestation. Like reflection in the mirror is a manifestation. Now the modifications of the reflection are also illusory. For example, if you are standing near the waters, still waters, no movement, and look into it, we'll see our reflection. And you put little bit dry twig, there will be small ripples. Because of the ripples, the reflection will also look as if it is broken, it is moving. But if you go into it, then you will come to know, although it appears that the reflection is moving and breaking, it is not. Because reflection doesn't exist. Like we can fish out the fish from the waters, can we fish out the reflection from the water? It doesn't exist. Be very attentive. Therefore, neither our original face is influenced by the modification of the reflecting media called the waters, nor the reflection in the water is influenced by the modifications of the water, because in one case it is untouched by the waters, in other case it appears it doesn't exist. Now apply it subjectively. Man is not miserable, husband is also not miserable. Because husband doesn't exist, it is only an appearance. But when the appearance is given a status of reality, then the samsara begins. See friends, therefore, aham ahankarasya vidneyah karta bhokta abhimani ayam, I am doing, then you suffer. See, this identification with the action, I am the doer. Identification with the joy, I am the enjoyer. And sattvadi guna yogena cha avasthatrayam ashnute. So this identified entity goes through the experiences of waker, dreamer, deep sleeper, etc. Then vishayanam anukulle sukhi dukhi viparyaye. So when things are happening according to one's choice, I am very happy. You know, who is happy? Husband is happy. Why? She has gone to my cave. Okay. He is miserable. She is coming tomorrow. See, friends, look at this world with this eye of wisdom. You can never, never be miserable. Therefore, this whole phenomena is like this. In absolute reality, there is no problem. In only matter, there is no problem. See, this example which I give a number of times. In electrical energy, there is no light. Only in the bulb, there is no light. But when electrical energy expresses through the bulb as light, then the world begins appearing. In the same manner, consciousness expressing through the matter as life, the world starts appearing. So the whole problem is only in identification. Body is not the problem, wife is not the problem, children are not the problem, identification is the problem. So the moment we are identified with the body, this world is created. But we go on inquiring, when the world is created? And we go into unwanted inquiry. I think Big Bang Theory, and it is, I think, the black hole. The world is created the moment we are identified with the body. The world begins from our gross body. See? So if we want to get rid of these worldly problems, the only solution is this much. Disidentify from the body. Never live as the body, but live through the body. Never live as the mind, but live through the mind. So the mind or the body, they become merely instruments through which the life is flowing. Now, the bliss aspect. Atmarthatvena hi preyan vishayona svatapriyaha svata eva sarvesham atma priyatamo yatha. The things are not dear to us for the sake of the things. The things are dear to us for our sake. In Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, this thought comes. The wife is not dear to the husband for the sake of the wife, but for his own sake. The son is not dear to the father for the sake of the son, but for his own sake. The food is not dear to us for the sake of the food, but for our own sake. But we are dear to us only for our own sake. So whatever is the source of happiness, we like it, we love it. And we love ourselves the most. There's no doubt about it. Because we are the absolute bliss. Therefore, tataha atma sadanandaha. On the basis of this inquiry, it is said, tataha, therefore, atma, the self, is sadanandaha, ever blissful. Tataha atma sadanandaha, nasya dukkham kadachana. There is no place for misery anywhere. Misery is not the reality. See, friends, if misery is real, it will never go. See? Therefore, tatha atma sadanandaha nasya dukkham kadachana yas sushupto nirvishayah atmanando anubhuyate. Because in the deep sleep, we all experience bliss. It is neither the Vishayananda nor the joy of achievement or anything. None of our faculties are functioning. And yet we experience bliss. So this bliss in the deep sleep is the bliss which is expressing from the Absolute. And for that, Shruti Pratyaksham Aitihya Anumanam Cha Jagrati. And then we can see in the Jagrat Avastha, we experience this. In the waking world, we are happy because of the things. In the dream, because of the imagination. In the deep sleep, things and imagination totally upset. And thus, when we analyze our experience, we come to discover that we are the source of happiness because we are uncreated bliss. Misery happens when Sat and Chit are separated. When Sat and Chit is one, that experience is Ananda. Now to understand, take this example. The sweet meat is in the plate and you are very eager to eat it. That time, this 15th chapter of Bhagavad Gita is not getting over. That is why I don't insist for anybody, chant Bhagavad Gita. They may chant, but attention, thoda aur dal do na. Urdhvam Unamata Shakam. But for crowd control, it is good. But nothing to do with the spirituality. See? So when the object of enjoyment is Sat, the joy or happiness happens after enjoying the object in the Chit, the knowledge, the tongue. When they are separate, misery. When Rasagulla is lifted from the plate and it lands on the tongue, mouth, eyes, everything closes. What is that? The division of Sat and Chit is closed. That experience where Sat and Chit are not separate, that is Ananda. So it is not the happiness of. It is not the experience of. It is not the existence of something. It is existence itself. It is knowledge itself. It is bliss itself. Satchidananda. Now this Satchidananda is covered by the Maya. This is the normal statement given. Now what is the Maya? Avyakta Nami Paramesha Shakti Anadya Vidya Triguna Atmika Para Karyanumeya Sudhiyaiva Maya Yaya Jagat Sarvamidam Prasuyate Sannapya sannapya bhaya ubhayatmikano bhinnapya bhinnapya ubhayatmikano sanganna sangapya sanga ubhayatmikano mahadbhuta anirvachaniya rupa. Avyakta namni paramesha shakti. Maya is the unmanifest, dormant potentiality of Paramatma. Avyakta Namni Paramesha Shakti. And what is this? Anadi Avidya Trigunatmika Para. And this is Anadi, without any beginning. Trigunatmika, it is made up of three gunas. And this is the ultimate power of the Lord. Okay, further. Karyanumeya, it cannot be directly known. This particular principle is very important to comprehend the truth. Every cause is established only by observing the effects. This is the rule. So, what is observed by us? A child. What is the first question? Hey, whose child you are? Main to Bhagwan ka hu, lagave. See? So the child is the effect and the cause is sought. If you are having cough and cold, then our friend will say, why don't you go to the doctor constantly coughing? So cough is the effect and cause is sought in the same manner. What are the effects? Effects are manifest. Cause is unmanifest. High fever is manifest. That because of there is high fever, it is unmanifest. See, karyanumeya, that which is established or that which is inferred from the effects, yaya jagat sarvavidam prasuyate, and it is because of this maya the whole world is created. Now one more deep and then together we'll understand. San api asan api ubhayatmikano. It is and it is not and it is both. This divine potentiality is not and both. Then bhinna api abhinna api ubhayatmikano. It is other than the self. It is not other than the self. It is both. Then sangapya nangapya ubhayatmikano. It is with and without and both. Last mahadbhuta mahat adbhuta. It is the most wonder of all wonders. And the teacher says anirvachaniya rupa. You cannot define what the maya is. Now to understand this principle of maya, many of us get lost in this funny thing called as maya. One by one we'll try to understand. First is maya means, ma means measurement. Measurement is different than the measured. See, how far is Bengaluru from here? 40 kilometers. So 40 kilometers could be anything. Space is not 40 kilometers. That 40 kilometers is a measurement in the space. 5 liters. What? Nothing measurement. But what is that? Oh, it is water. See, ma means measurement. Char mahanagro ka tapman. Ma. Abhiman. Man is measurement. So, ma ya. That because of which something is measured. Now, how it is measured? Our eyes can see only the light spectrum of violet to red. Vibhyor. Normal human eyes cannot go beyond this spectrum of light. And if we insist, whatever is seen by us through the eyes, that alone I accept. If I don't see, it doesn't exist. We are under the influence of maya. X-ray, gamma ray, theta ray, beta ray, bicha ray, all these rays, they are not seen by our eyes, but they do exist. Therefore, what is maya? Maya is that knowledge or experience which is gathered through any means of knowledge, and we insist that alone is the ultimate. That funny thing is called as maya. And because of this, the questions come. Have you seen God, Swamiji? Meaning what? That which can be seen by the eyes, that alone is truth. If it is not seen by the eyes, it doesn't exist. Think. This is maya. Karyanumeya. See? There was one politician, he went to the eye doctor. Now the doctor had to see whether his eyes are functional or not. So what the doctor will do? See the karya effect. So he is asked, Can you read this? He said, no. Then the doctor increased the size. Now can you read? He said, no. Then he increases that E to the size of 6 feet. Can you read it? He said, no. How come? I don't know English. Now that doctor, what will he do? See, if he has to check the vision, first effects are seen. See friends, karyanumeya. So we hold on to the effect and go to the cause. Karyanumeya. Now the third meaning, maya. Maya is yaya jagat prasuyate, from where the whole world has come out. So be attentive. Water is potential, its potentiality. What is the potentiality of the water? To exist as a collection in the form of the ocean. Now in the water there is nothing other than the water. But this potentiality of the water will make its effect on the water. So the effect of the potentiality of the water creates ocean out of water. We don't have ocean of stones. We don't have ocean of the steam. We don't have ocean of fire. Only liquids. Now when the water's potentiality made ocean out of the water, will the water get drowned in the ocean? And see the maya. And then what happens? When we look at the ocean, like the other day I told you, I was going from Miami to Bahamas by a cruise. And I was standing outside watching. So my friend asked me, Swamiji, can you imagine how deep water is here in the ocean? So I looked at him, I said, I don't answer stupid questions. He said, what is stupid in this? I said, tell me, whether water is in the ocean or ocean is in the water. He said, don't bring Vedanta, please. Truth is this only. Whether ocean is in the waters or the water is in the ocean. What is the reality? We ask, is there gold in ornament? So by this, what is happening? This is called viparyaya. The ornament has become the reality and gold has become the attribute. But what is the truth? Gold is the reality and name and form are superimposed on the gold. Exactly the same way. We think we are inside the body. No, the body is in us. When this understanding will become clear, then this maya will not trouble us. And how it will not trouble us? The sugar cane never suffers from diabetes. The fire never gets burned. The water never gets drowned in the ocean. The water never breaks when the waves break. See? Therefore, sangha api asangha api ubhayatmikano. Therefore, san api asan api. Can you show the burning power of the fire in this wooden table where fire is not invoked? Fire is the presiding deity for forms, rupa tanmatra. All the forms are supported by the fire element. But when we touch it, it is not hot. But when the maya, the potentiality of the fire, called as the burning power, when it is invoked, that particular form which was supported by the fire element is reduced to ashes. See, the more you reflect on this, like One lady asked me this question. Sahaji, excuse me, you look like Swami Anubhavananda. Do you know him? I told her, yes, no. What is yes, no? I know, therefore yes. But I don't know as you know him, someone other than yourself. So, yes, no, is not, and both. See, therefore, this infinite potentiality is the one which is creating the world which doesn't exist. Like, where are the waves? Are the waves a reality? They are mere appearance on the ocean. Is ocean the reality? No, it is only the water. Be very attentive. Like the waves cover the ocean and ocean covers the water, in the same manner, the worldly objects cover the sense organs, the sense organs cover the mind covers the consciousness. How the sense organs cover the mind, cover the sense organs? We are so lost in the objective world that we are not even aware that all the knowledge is happening through the sense organs. And one day our headache begins, we are not able to see the thing properly, there is a tension, and then we go to the doctor and the doctor tells us, can you read now? So when he tells, can you read now? That time, where is your attention? Is it on the object or on the eyes? What earlier, we were so much overpowered by the objective pursuit that we have forgotten that all this perception is happening through the sense organs. See, like when we start taking food, we forget everything. Laga. Dabao. And afterwards, jara jyada hi ho gaya. Every day the same story. Because the objects are covering our sense organs. See? And then the sense organs are covering the mind. All the time only satisfying the khujli, each of the sense organs. So we go with the begging bowls of the five sense organs and try to get the things, not thinking about anything beyond it. And from there, we go, and in one of the ashrams, it happened. With me, there was one very elderly, nice person. But when we go to ashram, we have to follow the rules. You, whatever you may be. So he asked, please give me one more idli. Nahi nahi, itna kaafi hai, do nahi milti, ek hi milti hai. Now a person who is a multimillionaire and he goes and says, give me one more idli, and that boy who is standing there, nahi nahi, aage jao. What kind of insult he must have felt. So the objects, the sense organs, then the mind. And when the mind covers the consciousness, we start behaving mad. Tumhare jaise kahi dekhe maine. I can purchase this whole ashram. Why? Because the mind is overpowering the consciousness. See, friends, therefore Bhagwan says, what is God realization? It's very simple things. Shitoshna sukhadukheshu jitatmanaha. When any kind of experience happens in our life, the equanimity of our mind is not disturbed. 50% God realization. See? Second thing, manapamanayohu prashantasya. When honor and dishonor doesn't change our poise. The world comes to us in the form of joy, sorrows, achievement, failure, etc. And the people come to us in the form of honor and dishonor. These two things are enough to destroy our equanimity. And when we are thus disturbed mentally, the divinity that we are is hidden. And then the Rakshasa comes out. See, friends, therefore this knowledge is important, knowledge of discrimination. Find out who is getting angry. Find out who is getting miserable. Therefore, in the morning meditation I told you, when we sit for meditation, be very clearly, talk to yourself loudly. Now I am nobody. And then see, thoughts come or not. But without correcting this error, we sit for meditation. And who is sitting for meditation? Mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife. Do you think when there is somebody, there will be no thoughts? Somebody is always having thoughts. Nobody is never having thoughts. So you just play. Nobody, nobody. Then you don't have to worry. Chitta vritti nirodha, no need. See, friends, many people have the same thing. Swamiji, I keep on talking to myself, you know. What should I do? There's a friend of mine in USA. He asked me, Swamiji, please don't laugh. I said, no, I'll cry. I talk to myself loudly. When I am in my room, I keep on talking. अब इसके बाद ऐसा करेंगे हम लोग यहाँ से वहाँ चले जाएंगे लेकिन गाड़ी में पेट्रोल तो है नहीं अब क्या करें ऐसा करते हैं डाल देंगे रास्ते में उसमें क्या बात है टू हुम आर यू टॉकिंग टू योर सेल्फ ऐसे दिस इज द प्रिपरेशन टू गो टू द मेंटल हॉस्पिटल व्हेन वी टॉक टू आवर सेल्फ अदर्स डोंट लिसन दिस इज द बिगिनिंग ऑफ preparation for entry. Then we talk to ourselves, others also listen or hear. Then it is being, getting the visa to the mental hospital. But such people, they say, I am very sentimental. They are not sentimental. Sentimental is like what? Like centimeter becomes the meter. They say sentimental becomes the mental afterwards. These things we have to observe. When we observe these things, then this will become very clear. Shuddha dvaya brahma vibodhanasya sarpa brahmo rajju vivekato yatha. When the rope is mistaken as a snake, that snake cannot be removed by any other means except by proper discrimination. The snake has bitten me. So, what discrimination? Now it will die. It has bitten me. It can't just survive. So, go to see that dead snake and then you will find there was never a snake. Exactly the same way, friends. See, what we think we are observing, seeing this world, it is not. What we are experiencing is only the images. Therefore, a whole life is only imaginary. Don't we imagine that I am handsome, I am beautiful, I am fortunate, I am honored? We don't know this, we only imagine. So if you have to imagine, why don't you imagine, Aham Brahmasmi? Imagine. This imagining that I am divine is called as bhavana. Nasti buddhihi ayuktasya nacha ayuktasya bhavana. Do this bhavana. Insist again and again that I am divine. You can see the distinct experience in yourself. But our bhavana is, I am most unfortunate. People's husbands are so nice. My one is a dumbo. Why did I get it? You can never, never be happy in life. You are only imagining other people's husbands are good. The grass on the other side of the fence is always green. When you go there, then you understand. Pilate is that. Don't get carried away by these projections of the mind. Then you will see, we are the cause of all our miseries because of this wrong bhavana. Do this bhavana. See? And when bhavana is associated with the finite, samsara begins. So when I associate bhavana, I am this body, not other bodies, samsara, I versus you begins. The second bhavana, I am not this body, then I am the jiva, papoham papakarmaham. Then the life is different. And when you do this bhavana, aham brahmasmi, the quality of the life will change. See friends, it is so simple, it's not difficult. And when we do this bhavana, aham brahmasmi, the mind will dissolve. In Tejo Bindu Upanishad, third chapter, this is a mantra glorified, exhaustively explained. And at the end it is said, there are 72,000 mantras. They will take you to 72,000 of places, but you will continue to remain in the samsara. See? Therefore, Shuddha Advaya Vibodhanasya, this Maya and impact of the Maya can disappear only when we come to discover that everything is in me, but I am not in them. How to understand this? Colors and forms, where are they? They are in our vision. For a blind person, there are no colors and forms. So vision is the cause, colors and forms are the effect. Cause is subtle, effects are gross. See. Then sense organs are in the mind. Mind is expressing as sense organ. So mind is the cause, sense organs are the effect. Therefore the effects have limitations. Eyes can only see, nose can only poke, ears can only hear. But mind is beyond them. Mind has no limitation of a particular color or form. Then mind is gross, consciousness which is expressing as mind is subtle. Therefore, as the objects cannot perceive the sense organs cannot know the mind. Similarly, the mind can never know the truth. Then, Bhagavan Ramakrishna Paramahansa used to tell one story. There was a salt doll. She wanted to go and measure the depth of the ocean. And she went with the arrogance and jumped into it. And I'll tell you how deep it is. Never came out. Exactly the same way. The one who started the inquiry, he disappears. And therefore, the masters who are established in the absolute, they do not claim to be extraordinary. On the contrary, realization of the self is it cannot have arrogance, because what is realization of the self? Earlier I was dumb. Can there be abhiman about it? See my friends, therefore these are the effects. Shuddha Advaya Vibodhanasya Sarpa Brahmo Raju Vivekato Yatha. So where is that snake? Is it on the rope like the bottle on the table? No. Is it encircling the rope? No. Is it in our eyes? No. Is it in our mind? No. Be attentive. Once you go with the right means to find out the snake and you come to know it is the rope, thereafter will you continue your inquiry? Nay, rope to mil gaya, lekin wo snake kahan gaya? Will you inquire? That is why I am insisting. Any question you ask, you get lost in this world. We are here only to know the self. And if you really know the self, it doesn't matter. Vedaishya sarvai ahameva vidyaha. That is worthy of knowing. So, sarpa brahmo rajju vivekato yatha. And rajastamas sattvam iti prasiddha gunastadiya pratite svakaryaihi. So this maya trigunatmika, and it establishes the three gunas. Here also these three gunas and the world. This is also a big bluff. Don't get carried away by this. World is recognized by us only three ways. Matter, which is inert. Dynamism or activity. And knowledge. Other than these three, there is nothing in this world. Then we ask the question, what is the cause of inert matter? Oh, it is called a tamo guna. Then what is the cause of dynamism activity? Rajo guna. What is the cause of knowledge? Sattva guna. And then something somebody injects in our mind that I am sattvic. I am not tamogani. Every guna is essential. There is nothing like good and bad. If you cannot invoke the tamoguna, you cannot sleep. If you cannot invoke rajoguna, you cannot come out of the sleep. If you cannot invoke sattvaguna, in satsang also you will sleep. See, my friends. Now, when the inert world is established because of the tamoguna, and tamoguna creates the inert world, so who is the cause and who is the effect? Like one child was scolded by the father, I gave you birth and you behave like this. So child watch, these days children are not born, they are downloaded. And the child asks, Dad, you gave me the user ID, what about password? So the father scolded the son. I gave you birth, you behave like this. Now the son says, Dad, this is enough. I gave you birth when I was not born. Who called you dad? So the father is because of the son, or the son is because of the father. What is the reality? Reality is man. When the son was not there, even then he was there. When the son will get grown up, get married and will be exported to NRI conditions, not real Indians. Fake Indians go outside India. And after going there, they teach how to live in India. See? Therefore, anything which is cause and effect is an illusion. Just discard it. So, these are the three gunas indicated. Now, don't take them very seriously. Understand the effect and get out. Viveka Shakti Rajasakriyatmika Yata Pravruti Prasutapurani Ragadayo Asya Prabhavanti Nityam Dukkadayo Manovikara. Kamakrodho lobas tathambasuya ahankarerdhya matsarya adi astughora dharma ete radasapum pravrutti jasma desha tajrato bandha hetuhu. When these effects are seen in our personality, vikshepa shakti rajasa kriyatmika. Rajoguna creates vikshepa and therefore activity begins. And yataha pravrutti prasuta purani. Therefore, because of the Rajoguna's activation, the whole world creation begins. And Ragadayo Asya Prabhavanti Nityam. and effects of this Rajoguna is raga, that is desire, kama, krodha, lobha, moha, madha, matsarya, raga, dvesha, ahankara. All these are the expressions of the Rajoguna. Such Rajoguni people are extremely workaholic. They just can't keep quiet. You must have seen these Rajoguni people. Once I was coming from London to Mumbai. Flight was almost empty. So I was sitting in the middle four seats in the corner aisle, hoping that when it starts, I can remove those hands and sleep. But one person came and sat on the other end of the aisle. Said, "All right, Baba, Bhagwan doesn't want me to sleep." And when we are going up, the whole seat was shaky. Kar, 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 kar. I said, "Yahan bhi speed breaker aa gayi kya?" And after, again it will start moving. So I was watching what is happening. So that gentleman who was sitting there, he was moving his legs vigorously. I asked him, "Jaldi pahunchna hai?" We are not aware because this Rajoguna is so overpowering, they just can't keep quiet. You know, there is these days one gadget has come in the market that you hold it like this and fidgetry. You keep on doing like this thing. Some people take the pen in hand, cut, 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 cut. In the flight also, they will be playing with the belt. Tuck, tuck, tuck. What is there to play? Rajoguna is overactive. And such a person, dharma iti rajasapum pravritti, such people are always workaholics. Tamoguna, esha vrittir nama tamogunasya shaktiryaya vastu avabhasati anyata. So tamoguna's effects are avrutti. The things are not seen as they are, but they are seen something else. And that something else is helped by the Vikshepa Shakti, the Rajoguna. And in this manner, Prajnyaman api pandito api chitaru atyanta sukshmartha druk vyalidastamasana vetti bahuda sambodhida api sputam prantyaropita meva sadhu kalayat tyalambate tad gunan hantasu prabala duranta tamasa shaktir mahatyavratihi. The wrong notions, once it takes possession of us, we are not ready to change. This is one of the reasons. It happened in Bombay that Amma is not coming, no, I don't know where is she. Her husband used to drop her for the talk and again pick her up and go for home. He never came for satsang. One day when I was going to his place for breakfast after the morning lecture, she asked me a question. He was driving the car, she was driving him, and both of them were driving me crazy. It is a challenge to go with the husband and wife together. It's a terrible experience. So she said, "Swamiji, some people are good, they are not bad, but they don't want to go to satsang. What is the reason?" Husband said, "Swamiji, aapke kandhe par rakh karke banduk mere par chala rahi hai." He is taking your excuse, but she is hitting at me. Then he said, "See, Swamiji, I like you, I love you, but I don't know why I don't want to come to satsang. I don't know. I just don't want to come." I said, "I'll tell you, but you're not like it." "No, no, tell me." "We are all living wrong notions. When we come to satsanga, wrong notions are hammered and destroyed. And then one comes to know, oh God, that means my whole life I was living the wrong way. No, no, better don't go there." See, like small kids, when they see something terrible on the Discovery Channel, etc., the tiger attacking the deer and holding the neck and eating it. The children don't know to see, they close, no. In the same manner, we want to continue living in the fool's paradise. Because our whole life is what? Living as the body, for the body, on everybody. Never beyond it. And when we come on the spiritual path, particularly the inquiry, Vedanta. See, when you come over here, all wrong notions are destroyed. Yoga is destroyed. Karma is burned. Upasana is ridiculed. And Kundalini is made fun of. This is called as Arthavad. Arthavad is what? When Hanumanji first time made Bhagwan Ramachandra in the disguise of a brahmachari. And Bhagwan understood him. And when he realized that Bhagwan has already understood me, so he presented himself in his original form. Then Bhagwan Rama hugged him and said, "You are more dear to me than Bharat." Does he mean that he was condemning Bharat? This is called an Arthavad. In the same manner, when this is said in the Vedanta classes, the yoga, karma, upasana, kundalini, it is not meant for condemning something, but giving the importance to this inquiry. That which is created out of wrong notion can be corrected only by correcting the notions. So our notion is, I am unfortunate. Now find out who is unfortunate. So I as a husband is unfortunate. Then find out, is husband the reality or the man the reality? Then you'll come to know the man is the reality. Then what about the husband? So don't take him seriously. That's it. Over. Your complete sadhana is over. See? No, I want to improve my wife. This is called as Ashakya Anushtan. See? You have to improve yourself. How to improve that? Accept your mistake. And be happy. When this is unnecessarily fighting, one Marwadi Amma, she was telling me before her husband, somebody you have seen, he told her to go and get a bottle of water for me. He stopped the car nearby. And the poor lady, she went and got, "Are beyokuf, thanda pani le aana." When he said like that, she got it. She says, "Swamiji, have you seen? He always condemns me, calls me beyokuf before everybody." I said, "Mama, I agree with him." "You also say like that?" I said, "Yes. Why? Unless you are beyokuf, will you marry this person?" See? A smart person will never marry this dumb fellow. The day you discover, always there is somebody who is miserable. So all the spiritual practice is discard this somebody and learn to live as nobody. But don't do like a Gujju. One Gujarati did it in Malsar. He heard this thing. Next time he came, he gave me a card. "Mr. Nobody. Address nowhere. Phone number, no, nothing. Job, nothing." He gave me. I read it. I tore it. So why? I said nothing. See, that is not the meaning. When you are conducting yourself in the world, you have to behave properly. Otherwise, you go for the interview. "What's your age?" "Unborn." When you are in this world, you have to conduct that way. Otherwise, whose wife is this? I don't know. See? Therefore, prajnavan api panditopi. One may be very well read, educated, and yet one gets contaminated, conditioned, and confused by this play of Maya. See, many times we try to be goody-goody. Please be attentive. Goody-goody characters are dangerous. They are not leading their life sincerely. They try to project themselves something holier than thou. See, be yourself. We don't have to prove anything to anybody in this world. Then you will see there will be no tension. Then what are the problems because of which we suffer in the tamoguna, abhavana, vipareeta bhavana, sambhavana, vipratipastirasya, samsarga yuktam na vivojjati dhruvam, vikshepa shakti kshapayatyajasram. Abhavana, I don't know. Viparita bhavana, knowing the wrong way. Sambhavana, always doubting. And vipratipatti is always questioning. These are the qualities of this tamoguna impact. Therefore, this one principle if you take, you have learned the whole Vivek Chudamani. And that one principle is, that about which you have no question, that is you. And this is only worthy of knowing. So we have no question about our being. How does it matter about anything? Anywhere you go, questions, questions, questions. We were recently, I think, in Australia. We went to some nice garden, old type. And I was going with my camera taking picture. And one beautiful long tree I saw. So from below I took a nice picture. So one person asked, Swamiji, what could be the age of this tree? I said, 387 days. How do you know? I said, calculate. Keep busy. How does it matter? Don't get lost in any inquiry. When you stop asking questions, be attentive. Mind dissolves in consciousness. Consciousness and mind are same. Consciousness plus thoughts is mind. Mind minus thoughts is consciousness. See? Man plus wife is husband. Husband minus wife is man. So what is the reality? The wife, the husband, or the man? See, Santokh, the day you start working on this line of thinking, nothing will disturb you. Ajnanam alasya jadatva nidra pramada mudhatvam mukhastamo guna etai prayukto nahi vetti kinchin nidra anuvat sambhavat evatishtati. And when we are overpowered by the tamoguna, then ajnanam alasya jadatva nidra, ajnanam, not knowing anything properly, alasya, not now after some time. Jadatva, dumb, nidra all the time in the Shambhavi mudra. Understanding becomes completely corrupted. Like somebody asked me, Swamiji, I am trying to do the Shambhavi mudra, it doesn't happen. I said, what is Shambhavi mudra? No, you have to open your eyes half. I can either open fully or zero. But half, how to open it? I am feeling disturbed. Can you teach me? I said, you are dumb. He said, how come? How many eyes you have got? Two. Half is how much? One. It's meditation. Don't get carried away by all this. That is not the purpose. Wrong notions must be erased. So, pramada is repeating the same mistake again and again. It's pramada. And what is the pramada which we are all victims of? Pramada is identification with the body, and thereafter living as the body for the body on everybody. How many times we must have heard it, but again the same thing. when I was young. Arre Baba, the body was young. Because we are not separating ourselves from the body, we talk about our past. See, do we talk about our dreams? See, 20 days before there was a dream, and in that dream I was mad. Come on, you are being modest. Now also, you are the same. We don't write autobiography of a dreamer because they are not real. Like for every dream, there is a separate dreamer. Exactly the same way, for every waking experience, there is a separate waker. If you can digest this, Hajmola, all your problems will disappear. And this is what we are told, live in the present. Yesterday's I and today's I are not the same. If they are the same, we will never grow wise. And also we will never grow otherwise. See, we are constantly different. That which is never changing is the real I. But we keep on writing autobiography of a Dumbo. I was born there, I was then, this happened, that happened. Do we write autobiography of a dreamer? No. Because when we don't give value of reality to the dreamer, then only we are out of the dream. In the same manner, when we are out of this waking dream, you will never think about anything related to the gross body and the gross world. See, friends, such a master abiding in the absolute, for him it doesn't matter whether the body falls in Varanasi or in a gutter. It makes no difference. It is for us, we only say. I remember one experience when Amma told me, Swamiji, you know my mother-in-law, she was so terrible monster. I said, yes, I know. And she has tortured everybody, her son, me, everybody. And to me, she was like a rakshasi. When I give her something to eat, she used to throw the plate. She tortured. But I served her. I said, that is your greatness. Continue serving. You know what happened? She died on Ashadhi Ekadashi. Now, will she go to Vaikuntha? Because I was planning to go there. She is also there. Then what will happen? Because they say when somebody dies on this Ashadhi Ekadashi, he goes to Vaikuntha. I said, Mama, don't worry, she will not go. Now tell me, the one who died on that particular day, did she know that today is Vaikuntha Ekadashi? No. The rule is, every gain is only through knowledge. You have got a lottery ticket in your pocket and you don't know your ticket has won the amount. And as usual, you are given your clothes for washing and you are that washing lady, she just shakes the pockets and she is one ticket, so maybe she gets it. And everything is done and she goes home and she realizes, oh, there is something she gives to her son. Dekho beta, is something for this ticket? Mummy, what is it? No, you try one, and he goes and says, 10 crores of rupees. See? When it is not known, it is not a gain. Gain is always through known. It's jnanendriya. Through karmendriya, we don't get knowledge. Karmendriya, only action. See? Therefore, Pramada is remaining in this awareness. Are we not repeating our same mistake? Whatever we are doing yesterday, today, the same thing. See? Therefore, Pramada Mudatva tamoguna. So dull wittedness, repeating the same mistake again and again. Therefore, whenever a student asks question twice, he is deleted. Not qualified. Only one go. This story comes in our Tripura Arasya. Parashuramji happens to go and experiences something good. So he asked that Mahatma, please tell me what is this? Oh, this is Brahmananda. Not explain properly, you are not explaining properly. What is the Brahmananda? He said, look here, you are intelligent, you require an intelligent teacher, I am dumb. Go to Dattatreya Bhagavan, he will teach you. And then Dattatreya Bhagavan mil gaya bakra. And he was given a stone. This is Tripura Devi. And you do upasana. Keep it on a comfortable asana. You should sleep on the floor. Give chappan bhog. You should eat only the grass. She should be in one place. You keep on running around. Give her warm water bath. You take cold water bath. And he continued for a day or two, 12 years, he got fed up. Went back. I think I have wasted 12 years. Who is this Tripura Devi, Tripura Devi? So the Guru tells, it has not gone waste. Now, because of this upasana, inquiry kindled in your heart. When you want to know, you stop doing. Till such time, you are engaged in activities, you don't want to know. This pramada is the cause of our bondage in this world. Nidraluvas tambavad eva deshtati. Always leading a dull-witted life. Then comes the sattva guna. And the causal body, will take it in our next class. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.